This is Dr. Vermilio. In this lecture, we'll review chapter 5 from the Kramer text on audiogram interpretation. We're going to discuss levels in terms of dB-SPL versus dB-HL. Recall that dB hearing level, or dB-HL, is a decibel scale in which the reference value is the minimum sound pressure level for normal audibility as a function of frequency, where 0 dB-HL at any frequency represents the average threshold level for normal hearing. This is from, the Kramer text, figure 215, and the y-axis shows sound pressure level in dB-SPL, excuse me, and the x-axis shows frequency in hertz. The dark line represents average thresholds for humans in dB-SPL. So this actually extends beyond our typical audiogram that starts at about 125 hertz or 250 hertz and goes to 8,000 hertz. This goes all the way up to, the graph goes all the way up to 100,000 hertz. And the low end, it goes down to 10 hertz. Now notice at 20 hertz, the range, or rather the average normal threshold for humans is 80 dB-SPL. So, can humans hear 80 dB-SPL on average, those with normal average hearing? And the answer is yes, if it's at a high enough level. So if it's at 80 dB-SPL, yes, humans can hear that. What about 10,000 hertz? Can humans hear 10,000 hertz? Well, the answer is yes, if the level is presented at, about 18 dB-SPL. So notice, across frequencies, the sound pressure level that's related to average normal hearing changes across frequency. Humans, the hearing for humans is most sensitive in this middle range over here. And this is the range that we're going to test with the audiogram. Here is the speech banana. Now notice it's a little bit upside down because the scale, on this scale, a low level is at the bottom and a high level is at the top. So that's the opposite of what we have for the audiogram. Anything above the threshold, now above the threshold means above the line on this graph, is audible. So a rock concert will be audible, a lawnmower is audible, conversational speech is audible, but anything below the threshold is inaudible. For illustration, here are the thresholds, the average thresholds for a cat. Now, I don't know how they got the cat to raise his or her paw during the test. Most likely they did this using the auditory brainstem response to estimate where the pure tone thresholds would be. If the cat could tell us, yes, I can hear that sound. Okay, so you get the picture. So these are average thresholds in dB-SPL. All right, just like I said, the solid line represents average normal thresholds for humans. Any sound above the level of the threshold by definition will be audible to the average normal hearing individual. Audible sounds, inaudible sounds. Okay, question for you. What is the average threshold in dB-SPL for a pure tone threshold presented at 20, where the pure tone is at 20 hertz? And the answer is, we already told you what the answer is, but again, look at the chart, 20 hertz. Now notice that this is 10 hertz. This is a logarithmic scale, so the spacing is in this logarithmic manner. So here's 10 hertz, that's 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and then 100. This is 100 hertz, 200 hertz, 300 hertz. This is 1,000 hertz, this is 2,000 hertz. This is 10,000 hertz. This is 20,000 hertz, okay? So what is the average threshold in dB-SPL for a pure tone at 20 hertz? And the answer is 80 dB-SPL. Now, can the average person with the normal pure tone thresholds hear a 20 dBHz tone at 60 dB SPL? What do you think? So the tone, if we presented through the earphones a tone at 60 dB SPL, would a person with average normal hearing for pure tones be able to detect that tone? The answer is no, because a 20 hertz tone at 60 dB SPL would be below the level of the average threshold. In other words, it would be inaudible for individuals with normal pure tone thresholds. What is the average threshold in dBHL for a pure tone at 20 hertz? And the answer was actually given to you a slide or two ago. So what is the average threshold in dBHL for a pure tone at 20 hertz? And I hope you got it. The answer is 0 dBHL. So what is the average pure tone threshold for a human at 80 dB, at 80 hertz, at 20 hertz, according to this graph? Well, the answer is 80 dB SPL. And so then 80 dB SPL, if that's the average normal threshold, what is that in dBHL? And the answer is 0 dBHL. So 0 does not mean the absence of sound. 0 means the equivalent sound pressure level for the average threshold for humans. Okay, what is the average threshold in dB SPL for a pure tone at 2,000 hertz? Okay, recall you have 1,000 hertz shown on the x-axis, the next line, because of this logarithmic scale. This is 2,000 hertz. What's the average threshold for humans at 2,000 hertz? And then we just look at the y-scale, y-axis, and the answer is 0 dB SPL. Okay, question. What is the average threshold in dBHL for a pure tone at 2,000 hertz? And the answer is, of course, 0 dBHL. Okay, so all the levels on this line, which is average normal thresholds for humans, the equivalent level in dBHL will always be 0. 0 means average normal threshold for humans, regardless of the frequency. So all the frequencies, the average normal hearing threshold is 0 dBHL. What about this one? What is the average threshold in dB SPL for a pure tone at 200 hertz? Okay, so we look at our line, pure tone threshold line, average pure tone threshold, and we go over here. So what is that equal to? Yeah, that's about 23 dB SPL. What is the average threshold in dBHL for a pure tone at 200 hertz? And the answer is still 0 dBHL. It's always 0 dBHL. Okay? Now, just to let you know, this line for average thresholds, this was obtained by testing several humans to determine their hearing in dB SPL, and then the mean was derived. So this is just the average threshold for each of these frequencies. This is the average across several individuals who presumably have normal pure tone threshold, a normal auditory system. Okay, here's that picture of our calibration setup, 500 gram weight on top of the earphone that's on top of this thing called a coupler, and there's a microphone in there. The signal goes to a sound level meter, and we can measure the sound pressure level in dB SPL. So earphone calibration includes the measurement of the pure tone levels in dB SPL. These levels have a corresponding value in dBHL. Now here's a table from the Kramer textbook, table 5.1. And notice that we have, this is the ANSI reference equivalent threshold dB-SPL, also called the RETSPL or RETSPL. And we have air conduction and bone conduction reference values corresponding to 0 dB-HL. So if you wanted to know what is the level in dB-SPL that corresponds to 0 dB-HL across any of these frequencies and see how it's different across the frequencies, look at this. Supra-aural earphones, 250 hertz. The value in dB-SPL that corresponds to 0 dB-HL is 26.5 dB-SPL. So when we measure this with our sound level meter and with the headphone on top of the coupler, we would like to see when the audiometer dial is set at 0 dB-HL, we'd like to see 26.5 dB-SPL measured on the sound level meter. But when we're looking at a 1000 hertz pure tone delivered through the headphone and the audiometer dial is set at 0 dB-HL, we want to see 7.5 dB-SPL on the sound level meter. Now, this is interesting. Look at this. Supra-aural earphones versus insert earphones for 250 hertz. The sound pressure level equivalent to 0 dB-SPL for supra-aural earphones is 26.5 dB-SPL. While the level in dB-SPL that corresponds to 0 dB-HL for insert earphones is less, it's 17.5 dB-SPL. Why do we have a difference? Well, note the level requirements for each pure tone threshold depends on the type of transducer used. The large difference in required levels for a low frequency 250 hertz tone is related to the type of coupling to the patient's head or the patient's ear. This table indicates that a higher level, 26.5 dB-HL, is required for a 250 hertz tone delivered through a supra-aural earphone, such as the TDH-50P, than when delivered through an insert earphone, such as the ER-3A. This is because low-frequency sounds can leak out of a supra-aural earphone. And when we say they leak out of the supra-aural earphone, they're actually leaking out of the ear canal. This leak for low-frequency sounds is not found with insert earphones. That's one of the pluses of an insert earphone. We don't have to deliver such a high level in dB-SPL in order to reach 0 dB-HL. An example of this would be a type of earbud that's used for listening to music on some sort of MP3 player. If you have a real good coupling with the ear, you're going to get a very, very nice bass response. So somebody could tell you, check out these earbuds. These are amazing. You know, you put them in your ear, listen to your music. The bass is cranked. It sounds wonderful. But then you go to the store, you buy them, and maybe they don't fit quite as snugly in your ear canal. Maybe there's some sort of leak, and you listen to it, and you think, this doesn't sound that good. It's actually kind of tinny sounding. I hear a lot of high-frequency sounds, but I don't hear this nice thumping bass that I really want to hear. And that's because of the coupling to the ear. So the answer is, or the question is, why is there a difference between the levels in dB-SPL that correspond to 0 dB-HL for supra-aural earphones versus insert phones? And the answer is because of the coupling to the ear, and supra-aural earphones have a tendency to leak the bass frequencies out of the ear canal, whereas insert phones do not. So now you can answer an essay question on that if you had an essay question like that on an exam. Okay, this is exactly what we just said. So if you need to copy this, go ahead and pause the lecture and copy this down. Okay, and we already said this point that all these levels are the requirements for test tones corresponding to 0 dB-HL. We didn't talk about this. We didn't talk about the bone vibrator. That's a special type of calibration. We're not going to address that right now. And then we also have the high-frequency earphones, which have a fairly good coupling. They have this, the Supra-aural earmuff, right, that goes around the ear. That creates a nice seal. So we see basically the same level in dB/SPL that corresponds to the insert phones, but it's different than Supra-aural earphones. Okay? All right. So the dB/SPL levels for average threshold or 0 dB HL are different across test frequencies, and that's what we just saw in that previous chart. The normal average threshold for any test frequency is 0 dB HL. RETSPL, you should be able to answer this question on your next exam. You should be able to answer these questions. Why are there different reference equivalent threshold dB/SPL or RETSPL values for different air conduction transducers at the same frequency? And why are there different reference equivalent threshold dB/SPL RETSPL values for different frequencies for the same type of transducer? Okay, so those questions you should be able to answer, and you should actually practice answering these questions. Once an audiometer is calibrated with a certain set of transducers, is it okay to switch transducers to another one with the same make and model? The answer is no. Even transducers of the same make and model will have slight variations in output across the frequencies. Switching transducers may cause your test system to become out of calibration and your test data will be inaccurate. So if you had a set of TDH-39P earphones plugged into one audiometer, and then you came in the next morning and they were gone, is it okay to yank the TDH-39P earphones from a different audiometer and just plug them into your audiometer? And the answer is no, because even though the headphones have the same model number, there are slight variations in the output of the earphones. And that needs to be taken into account when we calibrate. So note, the frequency response varies across transducers, even if they are the same make and model. Even if they are of the same make and model. Therefore, once the system is calibrated, it is not appropriate to switch transducers. If you need to switch transducers, then we must recalibrate. Calibrations should occur at least once a year. If you see audiologic test results that don't make sense, take a look at the last calibration dates on the test equipment. And that ends our lecture on audiogram interpretation, and we covered calibration and dB/SPL versus dB/HL.